Java. What is this? Broadcast video is live. Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about variables in Java. Variables are a way to store a value. So previously what you've done are things like robby.turnLeft, instructions. Those are all fine, but in case if your computer can't remember things, it's not very useful. Here's how we tell Java to remember things. If you want to remember a number, you have to give it a variable name. So we can go int x equals 5. The int means a number, an integer, basically any positive or negative number without a decimal point. X, that's what we're calling it, x, equals 5, the number 5. This will create a variable called x that stores 5. And we can use this just like we would use the number 5. So we can go system.out.println x. And what this will do, if we run this, we'll say 5 down here in the console, because x is equal to 5, and we told it to print x. We can do other things to variables, too. We can do math with them. So, for example, we could go system.out.println x plus 2. And if we run this, it says 7 down here. We can change the value of variables as well. That's why they're called variables, because they can vary. We can say x is equal to 2, semicolon, run this, and it says 4, because x is now equal to 2, and 2 plus 2 is 4. We can change the we can increment variables by going x equals x plus 1. So in this case, what this will do is it will take 5, it will add 1 to it, making it 6, and then it will print out the number 6. And we can see it does that. It says 6 down here in the console. There's a short form to do this as well. You can say x plus plus. That's called the increment operator. If we run this, it'll say 6 again, because plus plus is the same as x equals x plus 1. You can do the same thing with decrementing, too. We can go minus minus. And it'll say 4, because 5 minus 1 is 4. We can also store strings in variables. For example, if we go string x equals hello, semicolon, and print x, and we'll say hello down in the console. A string is any sequence of letters, numbers, special characters, spaces, anything you can think of. There are lots of things you can do with strings, and we'll be covering those a bit later. For now, hope you'll be able to make your programs a lot better by including variables.